What's up, everybody? Main Boat Guy here. We're going to be changing sea style, hydraulic sailing cylinder. It's going to be on an Evinrude. We're going to change a couple hoses. We've got some fluid. And we've got the Power Purge Junior. We'll start by unboxing this and see what we got. Little handy instructions. Definitely need those. So many different ways these things can go together, so good to have them. For the guys that don't have the Power Purge, that is your leader. That's going to hook to your port jug and then go up to your helm. And that's just for bleeding at the cylinder to get it into a container. Ground strap. Most guys don't install them. I will be installing that just to keep the corrosion down, salt water. Gonna connect from the engine up to the steering cylinder, keep it grounded. Installation hardware. We'll go through as much of that as we can. Adjusting the play. Because it's OMC, and then our hydraulic steering cylinder. These new ones have grease fittings on the tilt shaft, which is nice because it does help force a little bit of grease inside where the old ones didn't, and you had heavy corrosion, and then wet, that would stick and end up destroying the rest of the cylinder because one thing's moving but the rest isn't. So, one cylinder last year. These are twin cylinders because we've got 200s ETEX. So, I'm going to pull this one off, changing the hose because it's got a heck of a kink in it. Steering cylinder's leaking like crazy, and it's the old style cylinder, corroded, some pitting on the shaft, so just not worth messing with. So we'll get ready and start pulling this apart. Alright, so this one's got a tie bar, so we're going to disconnect tie bar right there. She's pretty corroded, so I've got some penetrating oil right now on it. Hopefully get that thing undone. And then that one right there, nut off the top. Then this unscrews, this little washer is threaded. Five-eighths nut there, three-quarter nut there, both sides.
Thank you.
All right, we've got our other steering cylinder installed, tie bar attached, adjusted. Now we're going to do the power purge with the twin cylinder kit to run to our Power Purge Junior. So basically, connecting up to the helm. We're just going to fill the helm using that air pump. And then, these connectors on a single engine or a single steering cylinder. Those two ends, we just go right on the bleeder screws. Right where I've got those mounted, and then loosen the bleeder screws. And this is going to attach to those two, doesn't matter which one, because we're only bleeding the air out. We're not looking for which one's which, so let me connect these real quick. Sorry, I'm blocking the camera. Turn the pump on, hope for no leaks, and just start filling through the helm. You can see we're slowly getting the air out of the system. So it's going to take a while because these lines were completely empty, and that's the good thing about this power purge is I've got about a gallon and a half of hydraulic oil in there, so good to see fluid coming through all the lines. That means at least so far I don't have any other leaks. We did do new lines going to the bulkhead fittings. We left the existing lines in the boat since they weren't weather cracked. So we'll let this run for a second longer. We'll get some more air in there, and then we're gonna turn. Oh, I'm not sure if there's a direction you're supposed to turn first, but we'll go hard to one side, keep spinning the wheel until we see absolutely no air. And then we'll turn the other direction and keep spinning until we see no air. Let's see if I can set my camera up so you guys can see what's happening. Prop this thing up. Oh, let's see. Probably not gonna work. We'll try it. that are pretty well air-free. So now we'll shut the pump off. And then we'll tighten up the cylinders, the bleeder screws, before we do anything else, just to not introduce any air back in the system. We'll disconnect it and test it again real quick, but that's pretty much it. Awesome system, this Power Purge is. Makes life so much easier if you've ever had to do one by hand with two people. This saves you a lot of time, a lot of effort, and a lot of fluid. You only put as much fluid in there as you need. You don't bleed out a bunch into cans and then not know what to do with them. So, hope you enjoyed. Hope you got something out of this, and see you next time. All right, we finally got the old cylinder off. She was a pain in the butt, a lot of corrosion. Put as much of that as I can on there, but going back and forth and phone calls, I ended up shutting my phone off, and keeping you guys out of the dark, in the dark. All right, so first thing is the threaded adjuster. And that's gonna go on starboard side on the tilt tube. Thread that thing all the way on as far as you can. And then, look in the book. Actually, we got one on the other side, so we can reference that one. That'll be faster. Looks like we've got fat spacers, stainless washers, one on either side. We'll do the stainless washer in first so that the plastic washer doesn't, spacer doesn't go over those threads. And then one of these bad boys. Just put the hardware on loosely for now. Second set of hands helps, tell you what. Not that you need them for a long time, but going back and forth. Now, because these are twins, and there is a tie plate, what I've had to do on that side is, got that mounted up like that, but we've got a tie bar with a plate right here. I've got to have that plate fabricated so it sits far enough back. So yeah, that's the only issue we got to deal with. We'll get that done, and next video will be the bleeding them out.